Okay, here is my garter carriage, the KG93E. And to set this up, first of all, you want to have your rails on, because the garter carriage will go over to it. I got it moved here because I need you to see something. But you got your adapter box, and this little part here fits right on, if I could see it, a slot on the back. The short wire goes to the side of my knitting machine, in my case the KH940. The long wire goes down to a surge protector, and then that's plugged into the outlet on the wall. Then from your adapter, you've got your sensor that's going to go up on the yarn mast. And then the curly cord gets plugged into the garter carriage. When you push this in, make sure you go down straight. Don't try to force it in. You may bend the connection on the inside there. So just be careful and things will go good. So now you're going to take your sensor, and the two prongs here are going to fit right in that square hole that's at the bottom of your yarn mast head here. You want to have the metal lever forward. But I do want to point out, when you're threading the yarn on the back here, there's three slots. And that's for the different size yarns that you could be using on your machine. Now that will stop, if there's a knot in the yarn, it will stop the machine from going, from continuing. If the yarn cuts, breaks, or it's at the end, and this comes down, it short circuits again, and it stops the garter carriage from continuing, and your work does not fall on the floor. So as you're threading it, you go up through the slots on the back of the sensor. You come up between the drums on the yarn mast. Now, that could go on later, and I do put that on later, but you come down through the eye, up through the wire guide. After I get that, then I will take the sensor and put it over the yarn. And as you see, the yarn keeps it up. So if the yarn breaks and that goes down, that's the short circuit and stops the machine, the garter carriage, from continuing. You do not need your wire guide in this case, but you probably want to make sure that this wire goes behind it and that the curly cord is going to go in front of it. Now, one time it did go behind this and it didn't cause any problems. When placing the needle into the garter carriage, you need to take this black lever here and put it between the slots of the white part, the end of the garter needle, for it to work properly. To cast on, you're going to put all three levers over to the right. Now, the G means garter stitch or rib. The C is for cast on. This is for auto return, so it'll keep knitting for you. And that's one row at a time. And that is, it shows the loops like it's knitting. I got to see what that means. But when I take the top lever here and move it to the right, it automatically moves the second one down so that it will stop at the end of the first row, and it will not continuously go back, because you need to hang your cast on comb after it casts on. Okay, this side here is to operate the garter carriage to the left, and that's to operate it to the right. But when you're casting on, the carriage can only work from right to left. Now, to start off, you want to have your garter carriage past the turnaround mark on your machine. Then you could turn the machine on. And then we're going to press the memo key. Now, this is for the 930, 940 machines. Some of the other machines may be a little different, so you need to look at your manual on that. Next, I'm going to hold the green part of this down, and I'm going to lift up the carriage so I can move it across. to just before the needles here. Now, see, it didn't really sit down right. It's caught on the top. It's not really centered. So you move it one way or the other until it drops down flat. You're going to take your yarn, and you're going to put it through the yarn guide. Now, I like to take a clip and still put it on the end. And then I get the yarn inside the guide there, and I move it up and down to make sure it's not caught on anything. Then I close the gate. Now, this is not hanging down very well. I would rather have that hanging down quite a bit. And I could use that to sew up the seam I'm going to have at the end. I'm going to make a baby hat and 2x2 rib on this. So first of all, I need to put my counter here to 1, so it's only going to knit one row to cast on. I have my needles out to forward working position, and now all I do is press the green button to start. If you don't have a clip to put underneath like I'm doing, just hold the yarn underneath until it catches on the first needle is all. Oh, and I forgot, you do want to put your tension dial to the setting that you need it at. In my case, I have it on 10. Okay, I don't have my left extension rail on. If I wasn't paying attention and didn't stop my carriage past the cast-on area, it would have gone off, fallen down, and probably broken. So you want to have both extension rails on. After this, I don't really need it. What would have happened was, if the rail was on, once it got past the turnaround mark, it would have stopped. So now, I need to hang my cast-on comb. And what I do is I pull the yarn out, and I'm going to make sure that one hook on the comb is grabbing that. And then I come over and just hang the comb on the stitches. Now I need to put my claw weights on for weight. I'm going to put 3 on. And now I need to set up to do the rib. Now for those of you that know how to do this, you could go ahead, but I need to first take the memo light off. One thing I did forget to mention was after you bring the Garter carriage past that turnaround mark, you want to make sure that the G light is lit. That means that it recognizes the Garter carriage. So now I need to select the 2x2 rib. So if you have any of these lights lit up, you want to press it to take it off. And I'm just going to press clear. Now I press selector 1. And then I press the step button. I press clear, and I need pattern 534, so 534, step again. Now it's ready. The green light came on. It's going to show row 1. This is just a one row pattern. Now also, I didn't need it before, but you got your point cams. And it tells you to put these. Now you got right and left, so make sure you got right and left. But you're going to put them on the end of your cast-on stitches. Now for the G point cams, you're going to put them one stitch in. And this one here, if you look, it says L1, or R1, I guess. And this one says 2, and this one says 3. So the last stitch is going to be knit as a purl. The last two stitches are going to be purls, or the last three stitches are going to be purls. So now I need to set my carriage to do 46, well, actually I'm going to do 50 rows. No, I'll do 60 rows. And I'm going to reset my counter here to 0 because that was just the cast on row. Now I could go ahead, lift up my carriage, and get it close again to the beginning of the knitting area. You don't want to go too far in because the carriage needs to get the needles underneath. So now when I press the green button, it's going to automatically, oh, I need to take my two buttons up top here and move them over to the left so that it will do a continuous back and forth. When it gets to the end of that row, it'll turn around or it'll stop and it'll come back this way. The C, as I mentioned, was only for the cast on. This I need at knit into the right, but it doesn't really matter because the lever 2 is now set at continuous. So as it goes, the counter is going to go down, and when it gets to 0, it's going to stop. Hopefully I won't have any problems, but if I get a knot in the yarn, it will stop on me. Or if the yarn breaks and the metal lever on the sensor there goes down, it'll stop. And I'll be able to come back and fix it. So this way here, I could go to another machine and work on another project, or I could go do my housework. As long as I'm within hearing of this, and if I don't hear it going along, chugging along, I come and check on it. And actually, if I will put this back down to 50 because the pattern called for thinner yarn and started out at tension dial 6. Because I'm using a thicker yarn, a 3-ply, I have it up to tension 10 because I don't want it to be too tight. Okay, something doesn't sound right there. Normally it will make a different noise when it's doing the knit stitch, but when it's doing something else, I think what's happening is it's touching the cast on comb. So let me hold the comb down as it's knitting to see if it stops that other little noise. That was it. Well, it's still making that noise. And I do see another problem here. It's not knitting correctly. So I gotta check. I think there's something wrong with the needle. I'm gonna have to replace the needle with a spare one that I have. So I'm just gonna stop it there, put my hands down on the green part, lift up the, actually I probably should take the yarn out, lift up the carriage, and move it over. And yeah, you could see it did cut it. So this yarn is probably a little bit too thick. I'm going to have to change the yarn and start all over again. Okay, the problem I had was I had my tension dial up too high. So I put it down to 6 1/3, or one dot after the 6. And as you see, it's working really good now. Now it's going to go a little bit here, and then it's going to automatically turn around. And this switch here is going to go to that side too. I'm not sure if you're going to see it in the video. Well, there we go. And the different noises you're going to hear from this is when it's doing its knit stitch and also the counter. And when I'm done with it and I sew it up, I'm going to have myself a nice little hat. A 2x2 rib hat for a little baby. Now the way I like to finish off hats on the top is I will transfer every other needle over and do what's like a picot hem, or basically you're decreasing the stitches in half. And I'm not sure if you could see how that is there. But I will use my lace carriage for that. And I think it was pattern number 103 to transfer every other needle over. And all I do is, when it's done knitting the 60 rows, I'm going to set up the pattern to 103, like I showed you before. Then I'm going to take my lace carriage over here on the right. I'm going to push it on the left. I'm going to push it to the right. That's going to select the needles, and when I bring it back again, it's going to take those stitches off those needles and transfer them over one. And I think I had 3 needles over here, or 2 needles, because the last needle, of course, can't be transferred over. Then I bring back all the empty needles and use my double-eyed needle, or you could use a tapestry needle. Cut the yarn. You only need 1 length of what I'm doing here. But if you want to cut 2 lengths, that's fine too. You're just going to have a little extra result. Do your gather and bind off. So just thread through each stitch. Take it off the machine. Sew up the seam. And there you got your hat.